Number 11 is looking at a new platform, okay? So, obviously, you know, right now we're on Facebook, and this is one platform, but there's a lot of platforms that are out there, right? Between Facebook, Instagram, YouTube, TikTok, LinkedIn, all these different types of platforms. And maybe it's the time that you could be putting in 30 minutes a day or 1 hour a day in order to try to learn a new platform, right? Maybe it's the time where you can actually figure out a new platform. Instead of being a lurker on a new platform, you can actually be a content creator, right? Maybe, you know, TikTok would maybe be a great example of that, or LinkedIn. It's kind of strange now that people are hanging out on LinkedIn, right? I still feel like I'm not used to that, but ultimately people are doing that now. They're kind of changing that platform a little bit, making it slightly more social. And if you create content on LinkedIn, you have a really good chance of getting a lot of eyeballs on your content, because people are there reading content, people are there to learn, and it's all, you know, everybody's there for business kind of a feeling. And so having good content on LinkedIn is pretty cool. The other thing is, like, you know, if you need to check out some people on TikTok, I'll post some links to different people on TikTok after I get off the live, and you can check them out. Some people that I think are doing pretty good job on TikTok in terms of mortgage and real estate related people, and you can see what they're doing. But maybe it's a time, you know, take 30 minutes a day and really just dive into a new platform, right? I mean, there's probably you probably have some different social apps on your phone that you're just a lurker on, right? You're just there every once in a while scrolling through, looking at the content, but not actually creating your own content. So how can you take this time right now and every single day, you know, dive into one specific platform and actually become a content creator on that platform instead of just being, you know, just being a lurker, right? Ultimately, if you're just lurking in the background, you're not going to get the same value out of a platform as if you're actually there creating content, being part of the value, being part of the topic, the conversation, that kind of thing, right? If you're just hanging out, watching, just being an observer, you'll never get the same value out of it. So ultimately, you gotta just go in and actually create content. So once you're watching what other people are doing, eventually, just follow their lead, right? Follow their, you know, you're gonna see people in every platform. There's different structures that work. There's different, you know, you can watch what's working and then just kind of be inspired by what's already working for other people and do something in your own way, but, you know, by being inspired by what they're doing. So that way you're not trying to just start from scratch. It's like, just go out and look at what people are doing that's already working and then just kind of mimic that, right? I'll give you an example. One time I saw an article from Forbes magazine, or from Car and Truck magazine or something like that. And it was called 7 Cars to Avoid in 2019, right? And I was like, man, that's like, you know, it was really, there was a lot of fear of missing out, or, you know, it was like, man, you really wanted to click into that article. And so I used that same concept of, you know, things to avoid, and I made a blog post called 7 Reasons Realtors Hate Loan Officers and Maybe Even You, right? And that blog post was my most shared blog I ever had. It got like 100,000 views because it was getting shared in realtor groups and loan officer groups and all over the place. And people, it's such a curiosity piquer, right? Now, I didn't just come up with that concept on my own. I saw a concept that was working for somebody else in a totally different industry, and I just mimicked what was working for them because that article had, I don't know, like 50,000 shares or something on it, you know, on Facebook. And so I was like, okay, well, obviously this is really a curiosity piquer. I'm gonna kind of copy what they're doing, and I'm gonna do it with my own style, right? So you can do the same thing with new platforms right now. Like I said, LinkedIn, TikTok, some of those kind of things, or if you're just a lurker on Instagram, maybe start creating content on Instagram, that kind of stuff, right? But looking at a new platform right now, it doesn't take that much time. You can just take 15 or 20 minutes a day to scroll through, look at the discovery pages, this kind of stuff, see what's working for people, and then create something, right? And you eventually just gotta jump in and you just gotta start trying stuff and skin your knees a couple times, you know what I mean, before you can ride the bike.